Hey everyone, I am the Duke of the Bump. Welcome to Let's Play Super House of Dead Ninjas. This LP was brought to you by Just Drop, who generously donated during the donation drive a while back. It took me a little bit of time to get around to his game, but hopefully it'll be worth it. Thanks so much for the donation, Just Drop. I know practically nothing about this game. I have been looking forward to it because it seems like it would be right up my alley. I do know that it is an action roguelike, and there seems to be a heavy influence on moving quickly. I did watch one video for this game a while back. I don't really remember that much about it. And I've only had the game open long enough to configure my controls and my options. There is an option for sort of this fake video scan line effect, like an arcade game, and I never really, like any game on a CRT monitor, I guess, I'm never really into that look, so I turned that off. But other than that, all of my settings and stuff is just the default. Hopefully that didn't mess up my video going full screen for a second. So, yeah, there's a comic you can read, but that wouldn't be very entertaining to watch in a video, so let's just jump right in. This is my first time ever playing this game. Totally original blind experience. Let me offer you a mint, okay? Okay, so do I have to select anything here? I guess once I unlock stuff, I can start selecting things. Weapons, upgrades, and other. Oh, I do have an option here. I guess that's just the color of my outfit. You've also got this one for free. So I can be a fuchsia ninja or a red ninja. I think I'll start with the red suit. Oh, there's like a randomized mode. That's kind of cool. You get kind of the Rogue Legacy effect by choosing this. Just a random set of abilities and stuff. So nothing much to be said about these. Default hand-to-hand weapon, average reach, quick to attack. Default projectile, shuriken. Makes sense for a ninja game. Okay. Lightning magic from the heavens. Cast a bolt of lightning from above, which kills anything it touches. Okay. Well, that all looks pretty good, so let's jump in. Select difficulty. Let's start with normal. The roof and user underground. Well, I don't want to do any custom levels just yet. On hard difficulty, we have another option here, transdimensional leakage. I think I will start with just a normal playthrough on the roof. Alright, so. Move, grab the pickups, drop down. Okay. Oh wow, this is very fast. Oh, I have to double jump here. Okay. It's showing the keyboard controls, but I am actually using my controller with this. The controller setup was very, very good in this game. Unlike a lot of modern games, it doesn't require an Xbox 360 controller. It has like a box you can click on for every action, and all you have to do is click on that box and then press the button you want to use for that action. So very easy to set up, and I appreciate the fact that it has universal controller support. That's kind of rare on PC games these days, unfortunately. Alright, so it wants me to use a bomb there, so let's go ahead and do that, and I can grab that purple gem. I know I'm not doing this as fast as I should, but magic, okay. So my magic button would be that. Okay, that seems pretty effective. Downward strike in midair, okay. So I sort of have like a little somersault effect when I'm moving from side to side as well. That's kind of neat. Alright, and... Okay, it looks like I can climb up these walls like in... sort of like Ninja Gaiden. That'll be my go-to comparison for this game, because Ninja Gaiden is the only ninja game I've really played. Don't forget to read the comic. I will, but just not on video. Because no one wants to sit here and listen to me read. Timer reset. Oh, I didn't even notice there was a timer. Okay. That's probably something I should pay attention to. Okay. There is an option to turn down the blood. And I might do that, not because I have an objection to blood in video games, but just because the ridiculousness of the amount of blood there is might get a little bit distracting. Alright, so I reset my timer again, which is good because I was getting pretty close to running out of time. So I'm assuming that this is all randomized, except for like maybe the tutorial stuff at the beginning. Okay, it looks like I have 5 units of health up there at the top. Not sure how long these towers are going to be. Okay, so every time I grab the timer, it looks like it resets back to 30. So 30 looks like sort of the max for the timer. I unlocked something. I don't know what that is. Oh, there's some sort of bar up there at the top, and my character is like... is all crazy. Okay, so that was rage, apparently. My rage time was 8 seconds. I guess you do that by, by like killing a certain number of enemies in a row or something. Alright, that was a close one. Alright, I'm unlocking a ton of stuff here, but I think I have to wait until I go back to the starting screen before I can actually see what any of that is. I can't pause it or anything. Well, I can pause it, but there's no see what you unlocked or anything. Okay. So I don't play very many games with timers, so this is going to be kind of a unique experience for me. Dang it! Oh wait, something reset my timer. Was it because I got hit? That seems weird. Maybe when the timer runs out, it doesn't kill you. It just does damage to you or something. All right. So underwater segment. You can sort of swim by tapping the jump button, so that's good. Don't like the look of that monkey. Well, I unlocked an achievement. Why can't I get in here? Do I have to use a bomb? No. Oops. Guess that was a bad idea. I bet. No, that wasn't it. Because those blocks look like they're breakable, but... Not actually sure how I'm supposed to get in there. Maybe I have to... I don't know. Oh, I have radical moves, apparently. That's good to know. Maybe it just goes on forever until I run out of time. Maybe I just have to make it as far as possible. I'm taking quite a bit of damage, especially after I fell on those spikes. This is the kind of game I would normally stream instead of doing an LP. But I asked Just Drop whether he would prefer a stream or an LP for this game. And he said it didn't make a difference to him. And since for all the other donation games I did LPs, I figured I would go on ahead and do an LP of this game too. That was a really good continue screen. Alright, so I guess let's, for this first video, let's keep going until I run out of continues here. Looks like I had 2 of those, which means I figure I have 1 more left. So I'm collecting letters over at the left there. Does that spell anything? E-E-A-M-I. Unlock achievements to access new weapons and items in the lodge, okay? Well, that was unexpected. I don't like these monkeys. And this is just a super, super fast game. This is a very weird game for me to LP, but I'm gonna make it work, damn it. So when you continue, it looks like you pick up right where you left off. So I guess you can think of the continues more as lives, maybe. Oh, I unlocked rage somehow. I'm assuming that comes from killing a certain number of enemies, because it seems to just sort of unlock over time. I guess I should be using more of these shurikens and stuff. I haven't really been making full use of those. Okay, so these guys explode, so they're probably a good candidate for shurikens. Looks like I can pick up my shurikens after I hit an enemy with it. Uh-oh. Or maybe maybe they just sort of magnetize and come back to me. Like the thwomp. What the heck hit me? Oh, I guess that blood dripped on me? I don't know. I really love the Mortal Kombat announcer, too. That is a, if they didn't get the same guy who did Mortal Kombat, it's a dead ringer for him. The Agile Mantis. Oh, so yeah, it looks like you can pick up your shurikens, which is pretty cool. Well, let's magic this sucker. Oh, crap. How much magic do I have? Oh, looks like that was the last one. I wouldn't really describe this guy as agile. I mean, he sort of just does the same move over and over again. Well, I got a lot of crap for that. Wow. Is my timer still going? I can't tell. Okay, so the timer pauses after you beat a boss. So, it's a good opportunity for me to kind of sit and take stock of my surroundings here. I'm almost out of shurikens. I used quite a bit of them on that boss, and I missed with most of them, so that's kind of a bummer. It looks like I did get my magic back, though. It's weird, I used my magic twice, but I should only have one of those. I guess maybe I got picked up something that refilled my magic and didn't realize it. Still can't tell if those letters spell anything. Yeah, I guess I need more of them. I thought it would be like Super House of Dead Ninjas or something, or something related to the title of the game, but that doesn't seem to be the case. Abyss of Nature. So we're in the second area of this game, and it looks a lot like Metroid. Crap! I'm not sure what that monkey actually did to me. Kinda sounds like Metroid too. Just a very creepy kind of alien atmosphere. Oh, I didn't have time to read that message, you jerk. Alright, keep an eye out for enemies that rear up out of the ground. Will do. I'm just getting achievements all over the place here. Kill named enemies for a guaranteed item or special bonus. Okay, so I guess the named enemies are like the bosses maybe? Oh, jeez. Gotta be careful around this laser. Shurikens and money. How much money do I have? Can I tell? I don't think so. Maybe it's just my score? It's possible that the money bag just added to my score or something. Whoa. I'm glad I avoided that statue. Oh man, that's a very grotesque animation on that monkey. I didn't notice that before. Jeez! Okay. So. Okay, so those spikes fall. That. Should have seen that one coming. Alright, last continue. Let's make this a good one. Love the look of this game, the animation and everything. Very, it's kind of similar to Shovel Knight in that. It's obviously very retro-inspired. I mean, like I said, it looks a lot like Metroid. The cutscenes look sort of like something you see on an NES, but even though they're retro-inspired, I guess I need to bomb that. I guess I don't need to bomb myself. Like, even though they're retro-inspired, they don't try to stick to things they could only do on an NES. Like they don't limit themselves technologically, even though the game kind of mirrors that look. Oh dang it! I did not know that guy would drop a bomb. All right, I'm out of continues. Let's see what happens. Oh, that was. It was pretty gruesome. Okay, that guy doesn't sound exactly like the Mortal Kombat announcer, but very reminiscent. Alright, so how'd I do? I killed three friends? Who are the friends? 138 floors, that seems pretty good. Lost 19 lives. I guess every hit point is a life in this game. Well, let's see what I unlocked. The cursor was on play. Bump off spite to get this. Wait, what? I don't know what that means. Nunchucks. Instant attack, but has the shortest reach of all the weapons. Taming Whip of the Mini Nuns. Okay. Shuriken of the Headless Brotherhood. Makes a shuriken always behead enemies. Well, that sounds like a pretty good upgrade. And I didn't get any upgrades to my bombs or magic. What about these? Are these like passive upgrades? Plus 10 projectile upgrade. Yeah, that's what it looks like. Plus 1 magic upgrade. Okay, so these I don't have to activate. These seem like they're always on. Unless there's something special I have to do to actually use these. It doesn't give me the opportunity to select it. And other. I guess this is just cosmetic stuff. This is where my extra costume is. Each rare pickup increases your time up to 60 seconds. Okay, I guess these are always activated as well. Makes monkeys flee from the player. Oh, that sounds good. I don't actually know if these are selected or not. With the costume, I definitely select it if I want to use it. But with this, I push the button and it doesn't seem to do anything. So, maybe these are always on. Because if the monkey always runs from me, that seems like a pretty good deal. 60 seconds total in the air. Oh, I guess that's what I had to do to unlock it. I spent 60 seconds total in the air, and this is now available. So what I do to unlock this? Maybe I have to do these before these become available to me. Like, maybe the chance to get the upgrade unlocked, but I don't actually have the upgrade yet. In which case... I'm not sure. I guess I will have to find out in the next video. This has been the intro to Let's Play Super House of Dead Ninjas. I hope it's been enjoyable. Tune in sometime soon for the next update. And Duke of the Bump. Goodbye.